Morning, guys.
What are you here again?
Of course. Who else would it be? I'm on my way to the gym now. The time is now 7 o'clock, and I finished with one of my best clients, Jasmine. Just smashed another session today, which is great. Just gonna come at you, like literally just now, because this morning, about the subject of like really just getting up and going towards your fitness goals. And I talk about it all the time, and it's one of those things that really, really pisses me off, that people don't kind of get up out of bed and get active and just get moving and that sort of stuff, all right? I mean, I'm in this job because I'm passionate about it and because I love it, all right? And it's just really quite annoying that people get offended when I ask them, how many sessions did you get in? And like, people just look at me like I'm asking them a crazy question, or as if I'm trying to take the mickey out of them. You know, it's a real life question. How active are you? How much work are you doing? Are you reaching your fitness goals? Simple, all right? And I don't mean to rant, because I rant all the time and I moan all the time, but that's only because we live in a world that isn't perfect. Do you know what I mean? I have my own perfect perception or ideal of the world. It's not that way. People don't get out of bed in the morning. People don't go to the gym. People just do nothing and eat, and then they wonder why they're not hitting their particular goal of size, strength, however lean they want to be and that sort of thing. Don't get it. It's not me that don't get it. It's them that don't get it. And it might be you who doesn't get it. First and foremost, you have to set your fitness goal. Once you've got your fitness goal, then you have to work out how much you have to do to be able to get towards your fitness goal. Simple as that. If you're having problems getting up and out of bed, then remind yourself of why it is that you want to hit what you want to hit. Yeah? If I wanted to lose 5 pounds, let's say 2.5 kilograms in, let's say, the next month, then there should be no reason why I couldn't hit that. And if you don't hit that, then what's the thing that's standing in your way? Is it that you don't get out of bed in the morning to go and do that thing that you planned in your mind would be so magical and amazing and get you to where you want to be? If you're sitting miles away from your goal, then you need to set yourself a plan, okay? Say to yourself, right, I'm gonna train, and I'm gonna train hard. I'm also gonna hit my training, 4, maybe 5 times a week. Start off small, maybe, I don't know, half an hour each one of those 5 days. Make sure that you have ample rest in between your sessions, so you maybe have a good night's sleep, at least 8 hours. You maybe take a couple of days off, you know, midweek, and you train towards through the weekend and that sort of thing. I don't know, you work it out yourself, all right? But I think each and every single one of us has an idea in our mind, and we kind of know where we're going with this. We're all human beings, all right? We all have common sense, or at least I think we do. Don't know, do you have common sense? I don't know. Let me give you an example. Myself and my training right now, I'm training with hypertrophy, and my rep range is between 8 and 12. I know that. I know that I need to be hitting the gym from Monday to Friday doing push-pull legs. Alright, so that means, for example, Monday push, Tuesday pull, and then legs on the Wednesday. Alright, push on the Thursday, and then pull it on the Friday. The following week, then we're going to start on Monday with the legs, and so on and so forth throughout the week with push, pull, legs. Alright, and it's just going to constantly change like that. I'm taking 2 days off. Those 2 days are on the weekends, Saturday and Sunday. Simple, that's my plan already, all right? I know how many reps I need to do. I know what exercises I need to do, because it's simple, push, pull, legs, all right? So I'm pushing, it's gonna be my bench press, my overhead press, etc. The other one's gonna be pull, pulling in towards myself, okay? Pulling myself up in towards the bar, lat pull downs, pulling the bar in towards myself. Bent over rows, blah, blah, blah. Legs, obviously, the king of all leg exercises. The squat is gonna be in there. We all know this. So that's my plan. What's your plan? I need to calm myself down a little bit. I had pre-workout. But in all seriousness though, get yourself together, write down your plan on paper, work out how many repetitions you're gonna need, how many sets you're gonna need, how many different exercises you're gonna need, all right? You'll probably find that you don't need as many as maybe you're thinking as well, all right? Like I said, start off small, maybe half an hour will do. Half an hour is good, do you know what I mean? Some of my training sessions only last about 40 minutes from start to finish. But I tell you what, all right, they're some of the most intensive exercise sessions that I could possibly do. It doesn't always have to be an hour or an hour and a half of absolute rubbish doing nothing but spinning your wheels or just sitting there resting in between your sets. Gotta work hard, all right? Work it out. Anyway, guys, listen, I'm gonna be off to the gym now. Get myself down Oxford Street to East Gym and work out. Oh my God, this guy's a lemon. Get myself down the road, go train, work it out. Until next time.